So we could start. Bonjour à tous, bonjour à vous qui êtes en live, mais bonjour aussi à vous qui allez voir cette conférence en replay. Ce soir, on a l'immense honneur d'avoir Reg Laney avec nous. Reg est considéré comme le multi-award vital coach. C'est le coach vital le plus reconnu et le plus extraordinaire à Hollywood. Il a coaché Al Pacino, Hugh Jackman, Halle Berry, Suzanne Sarandon et bien d'autres. Je vous laisserai découvrir sa page. C'est une personne absolument incroyable qui est un être humain délicieux. On s'est rencontré au mois de février dernier lors d'un séminaire et tout de suite, on a parlé et nous sommes restés en contact. C'est quelqu'un d'accessible qui est extraordinairement gentil, enfin à l'écoute, disponible, enfin bref, tout ce qu'on peut rêver d'un coach à son niveau. Et j'ai déjà beaucoup appris de lui. I'm so great to introduce you to make this conference. It's an honor for me and I would like to thank you first because that's exceptional. It's a great moment for me and it's a great moment for everybody to share your values, your program, your visions, your story. And we are very, very happy to discover you and to discover all your programs.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very, very grateful to be here with you and excited to share some time with you together as well. It's a real honor for me.
Voilà, ça c'est Reg. Il vient de dire que c'est un honneur pour lui. Alors, bon, voilà, vous voyez, c'est Reg. Voilà, il est d'une grande générosité et c'est ça que j'adore chez lui. Reg, thank you. It's awesome to hear these words. The honor is for us. So, pour ceux qui ne connaissent pas Reg, Reg va se présenter. So, Reg, French people doesn't know you well. They heard about you, some stories, some okay. This is the coach of Al Pacino, okay. But in real, we don't know how your energy was born, how your vision was born. Can you present yourself and explain us how your program, your energy was born?
Simply. Well, my energy comes from passion. I always feel one of the most important things that I guide my clients and students through is to be true to themselves, to find their passion. People always ask me, well, how do you wake up so early? I'm an early bird. I usually wake up about between 4:30, 5 o'clock every morning, and I wake up full of energy and excited for the day, no matter what day it is. But yet it seems a lot of people I talk to, it's Monday or it's Tuesday, and they kind of got to drag themselves out of bed. And they have very low energy and they don't enjoy their life. And I say, well, if you don't wake up excited in the morning, then you need to be aware of the choices that you're making, the life that you're living, right?
Alors, be aware pour les Français, c'est plus conscient, hein. c'est pas le aware de... un certain Jean-Claude Venant. Be aware, ça veut dire bien conscient de ces journées. How was your program was born? Okay, you have the patient, but can you remember the day où Reg Laney said to himself, okay, I would like to be a coach? How it was born?
Yeah, that's a good question. The day I decided to become a coach, I didn't even really realize I was a coach until people started telling me I was.
Okay.
I started out in the medical world. I wanted to be a doctor. And that came from, I was born into a family of a lot of illness. Everybody in my family has died of cancer,
Okay.
My dad was diagnosed with cancer a couple of months before I was born. And he survived for 15 years. So for the first 15 years of my life, I watched my father go through 9 operations where they took the top of his head right off 9 times. Chemotherapy, drug radiation, you know, all kinds of different things. And my mother was very much into alternative care. So she wanted to help him with foods and with, you know, beliefs and exercise and different natural things, you know. Okay. And so I saw this balance kind of between when he was doing natural things compared to what he was doing the medical things, you know, and it really interested me. And I remember there was one pinnacle point. I was probably around 13 years old. And I remember my dad used to get on the floor, and he used to get headaches so bad that he used to pound his head against the floor. And I asked him, what are you doing? Like, why are you hitting your head on the floor? And he said, well, I'm hoping that the pain will go away. So the pain was so bad in his head that he thought by hammering his head would make it feel better, you know? Okay. And I remember, you know, 12, 13 years old, but I went and I just started rubbing his head. I had no idea why. I'd never seen anybody do it before. I'd never done it before, but I put my hands on his head and I started rubbing him. And he just laid right down. And he calmed right down, and he, after about half an hour or so, I'm not sure exactly the time went by really, really fast. Okay. You know, he said, oh my God, you know, he said, my head feels so much better. You've made me feel better. And I was like, wow, like, how did that happen? What's that all about? So that's kind of what really got me interested in the body and health and wellness. And I just started asking questions from there.
Okay, but your first patient was to be a doctor. It was your goal. Okay,
that was my goal. Yep.
Your first goal.
Yes.
And after, can you explain the new direction?
Well, I got about 4 years into medical school, and I just realized it wasn't for me because I was asking questions that they didn't want to answer or that they didn't even want to get into a conversation about.
Okay.
So, you know, about nutrition and about beliefs and about environment and about, you know, alternative healthcare. Mm-hmm. And they're like, no, 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 you don't even talk about this stuff. You know, we just learn this and that's all we learn.
Okay.
So, you know, and my brain couldn't work like that. I couldn't rationalize that. Didn't make any sense to me. You know, it's not that I believe that anything else worked, but at the same time, I didn't believe that nothing else worked, you know. I always thought that, you know, there's what's wrong with looking at other alternatives? What's wrong with asking questions? And it's funny, you know, because that was, you know, over 40 years ago.
Yeah.
And the thing is we haven't progressed much, which is a scary thing. Because even nowadays, you know, I work with people with cancer now. It's my passion. I have clients all over the world with cancer. But, you know, their families, they just think I'm the craziest person on the planet. And my grandmother thought my mother was the craziest person on the planet, you know. And I wonder, well, I still can't understand that. Like, why can we not think outside of this very narrow box? Why can't we, one, ask ourselves why we get a disease?
Yeah.
Where does the disease come from? And why is it that some people can get a disease and then get rid of it? Other people get a disease and they keep it for many, many, many years. And other people get the same disease and they die from it. What's the difference? So I like to ask questions and I like to get to the root cause of issues. And I find it very strange on why we can't, as a culture of human beings with very intelligent minds, why we can't think about alternatives. We can only believe that, you know, these guys with the white jackets that are whatever, however they're trained, that's the only way to take care of things. Okay. So, I got out of medical school. I just thought, you know, I can't go down this road. You know, my mind won't allow me to do this. So I went to India. And I started training in Ayurvedic medicine.
Okay.
I became a doctorate of Ayurvedic medicine.
Okay.
And then I got into the traditional Chinese medicines.
Okay.
And I studied for many years into those. And into that, I realized also it's not just medicine. You know, it's not just about caring for the body. It's more about caring for the person and understanding what really is going on. and why people get sick in the first place. And I started looking into environment, started looking into foods, mm-hmm. and started looking into beliefs and choices and how people work. And that's pretty much how I've now developed the system that I work with now. And, you know, I host these retreats and workshops and training seminars, all kind of around my book, which is called Be You. And yeah. I think you have a copy of my book.
Yes, yes. I have to show it's Be yeah. You. It's a 10 vital keys to living an extraordinary life. The title often is exaggerating, but this time it's not, because I read the book, even if my English level is a school level, you know, but it's simply to understand the words I good chosen. You have some schemas, some vous avez des schémas en fait qui sont très simples. Excusez-moi, c'est vrai que j'ai pas pris le temps de vous demander si vous comprenez. Est-ce que la compréhension, est-ce que vous pouvez me dire si au niveau compréhension tout va bien? En gros, voilà, ce que j'ai demandé à Reg, c'est nous dire un petit peu son parcours, où était née l'origine en fait. Got it all, ok. Merci Michel. Alors Michel, je sais que toi tu parles bien anglais. Mais tout ça pour dire que voilà, le livre de Reg est vraiment vraiment accessible en fait. On n'a pas besoin d'avoir un super niveau pour comprendre. Et c'est vrai que c'est limpide et là c'est très bien fait. Regardez par exemple voilà les 10 keys, c'est absolument clair là-dessus. Alors j'ai une jolie dédicace. Thank you Reg for your words. The book. It's a collector now. I'm yes. so happy. And yes, so BU, BU is the 10 vital keys. It's about your course, your patient first, who was you have an evolution because your vision changed. And so you turn around the beliefs, the environment, the foods, and you have built 10 vital keys. Can you explain the 10 vital keys?
Yeah, well, it basically, to make it as easy as possible, it all comes down to, it doesn't really matter the foods you're eating. It doesn't really matter the exercise you're doing. Okay. It doesn't really matter the religion that you have. It doesn't really matter the education you have. What matters is that you're being true to yourself. You know, we are raised for some reason on a planet where we are born with very natural and unique gifts. You have gifts different than I have gifts. The audience has gifts that nobody else has. But yet we are all told to stifle our gifts, to not use them, to conform and to become like everybody else, and to do things only the way that we're taught in school, or only the way that we're taught in religion, or only the way that we're taught by our governments, or our societies, or our cultures.
Okay.
And for me, I believe that is the problem. That's the core of the issues.
Okay.
And because you see all the time, you see many people, they eat all the right foods and they exercise, but they still get sick. Mm. They're still depressed. You see people like these celebrities who they get the perfect job and they make money, more money than they could ever spend. They have everything they could ever want, but they're miserable and they still get sick and they become drug addicts and alcoholics and abusers, you know. So what really is the answer? You know, and I keep coming back, the answer is to be honest with yourself and to be you. You know, we have to be aware of all these things. I mean, how we fuel our body is important, but it's not the most important thing. You know, and our environment is very important, as is our relationships and our life choices. But first and foremost important is to become wise, is to gain wisdom, about who we really are and what we really want, and remove the masks. You know, remove the barriers, remove the limitations that other people put on us and we put on ourselves. And okay. when we get to that point of honesty and of truth and of mm-hmm. really being you, well, everything else becomes very easy.
Okay. You know? So for you, being you is the first key, is the main key to
everything.
To everything. Oh, yeah. To everything. Okay. So be you is to be honest, but what is it more? Be myself. Maybe I know what it means. Maybe I don't know. And how be you and you, how can you help us to touch, to discover what is being me?
Yes, exactly. Well, that's exactly what my courses and what my training seminars and my retreats and everything is all about.
Okay.
I guide people through that process because it's like unbrainwashing. I mean, if you go to a playground and you go hang around children who are 3 to 5 years old, they know exactly who they are. Right? They have no limitations. They have no barriers. They don't care what color anybody is. They don't care what language anybody speaks. They don't care about anything.
Yeah, true.
They are who they are, right? And this kid's good at doing that, and this kid's doing something else. And then what happens is we get educated to become somebody that we're not and to live a life that we don't belong in. So my training and my coaching and mentoring is all about resetting those patterns.
Okay.
Questioning your beliefs, getting clear about who you really are, what your superpowers are. I always say that my superpower is to help you find what your superpower is. That's one of my passions. That's what really excites me.
It's a nice sentence.
I love it. I love it because, you know, I tell you, when that spark goes off, when somebody gets that, this is who I am, you know, that becomes super exciting. And from there, you know, if you've got weight issues, you have health issues, you have body issues, you have depression issues, you have addiction issues, they almost all go away. Almost immediately, almost effortlessly.
Okay.
Because now you're focused on becoming the real you, and you start educating yourself about your superpowers and about how to use them better and how to do them better, and you start looking for ways to live your life using those things that come naturally to you and that you're passionate about doing. And then you know what? When you start living your life like that, you start waking up early in the morning with lots of energy. You stop eating all the junk food, all the comfort food. You don't need comfort food because you're comfortable living the life that you're living and you're excited about it. So you don't go and buy the crap food because you're too busy living your life. You know? So that's my excitement. That's what I love to do.
Okay. And it sounds good. It sounds good. Okay. So imagine I discover, be me. That's tower. That's I don't know. That's my passion. That's okay. What I understand is if I discover what means be me, whatever the food I take, I will not ever sick.
No, like I said, and I did mention that. It is important the foods that you eat.
Okay.
And it is important the environments that you live in.
Okay.
And it is important the relationships that you have and the people you surround yourself with.
Okay.
And the choices that you make and the things that you do. But what I'm saying is people are grasp at those.
Yeah.
They think that that is what they need to focus on. Mm. If I have a weight problem or if I have a health problem, I have to focus on the foods that I eat and I have to exercise more.
Okay.
Well, no, that's totally wrong. Mm. 100% wrong. Mm. Because you see people who are eating healthy and exercising healthy, but they're sick.
Yeah.
So clearly that's not the most important thing to focus on, right?
Ok. Oui, ça, c'est une notion très importante. Alors, est-ce que... Alors, dites-moi, les... Dites-moi, vous qui nous écoutez là, bon, c'est passionnant, donc moi j'adore Reg aussi, puis je découvre à chaque fois de nouvelles choses, mais dites-moi si au niveau compréhension, parce que là il vient de dire une notion très importante, c'est vrai que bien se connaître soi-même, être soi-même, be you, be me, c'est. Vraiment la clé de tout et ça vous aide à, ben, à vous donner l'énergie pour vous lever le matin, ça vous aide à rester focus sur vos problèmes, à vous permettre d'évoluer de manière épanouissante en fait. Et évidemment que ça ne protège pas tout, mais c'est le moteur, c'est le bon carburant en fait. Thank you Reg for this. Maybe What is your proposal about the your program about the 10 keys? What is the main you know the main energy, the main value about your program?
Well, I go through the 10 keys. I yeah. guide people through the 10 vital keys.
Okay.
But we start off with assessment. Assessment. Is vital,
okay.
vital key number one. And what I mean by that, you know, when you think assessment, you think I'm going to go to a doctor and I'm going to get x-rays and I'm going to yeah. get blood tests and I'm going to get all these things. Well, I go much deeper than that. You know, okay. again, those things are important. And if I'm working with somebody with cancer or with an ailment, I want to know, you know, what is going on inside the body. So I know what I'm working with.
Okay.
But also, even more important than that, we start getting down to the vital key of who you really are.
Okay.
You know, what is the life you really want to be living?
Mm-hmm.
What are your superpowers? What's holding you back?
Okay.
You know, if you wake up in the morning and you roll over and you look at the person that's laying in bed beside you, are you like, oh, God, how lucky am I? Or are you like, oh, my God, am I still with them?
Okay.
You know? And or how about the environment when you're coming home from work? Are you excited to get home? Are you looking forward to getting home? Is your environment a place that you love to be? Or is it that, you know, I don't feel so good there?
Yeah.
You know, and the same with your work. When you're going to work, when you wake up in the morning, are you excited about going to work and spending 8 or 10 hours doing something all day long? Or is it killing you?
Yeah.
I mean, how many times do you hear people say, oh, it's killing me? Well, they're absolutely right. If they're doing things that are against their core beliefs, their core needs, their core wants, they're not doing the things that they want to be doing in the way that they want to be doing it, it is literally killing them. You know, it's very slow suicide. So we go through all those things, you know, and yeah. that is the first and foremost, most okay. important thing to go through in the program. And then from that point on, we start getting into fueling your body rather than filling your body. And we go into body wisdom, self-analyzing your body. You know, how do you use your body? How do you move your body? How are you inside of your body? You know, and then we get into relationships and environment and exercise, you know, and all these different very important vital keys.
Okay, so okay, the first step is evaluation, assessment, right?
Yes.
And all your work after you déroule ton programme, you adapt your program with 10 keys, the 9 keys to coach the person. That's right.
Yeah, well, the online program,
yeah.
What the great thing about it is it's not asking you to fit into my program.
Okay.
What it is guiding you to design your own program. I guide you through designing the perfect program for you. How to live your life, the type of foods that you need, you know, the type of exercise that you like to do. There's no point me taking you to the gym and giving you the same exercise routine that everybody else does, like most personal trainers do. If you and your wife and your friends all went to the same gym and all hired the same trainer, chances are you're all going to get a very similar training program.
Okay.
But what I guide people through is to create the program that works for them. You know, most of the clients that I work with don't even have time to go to the gym. They don't want to go to the gym. They don't like the gyms. They don't want to. So I will guide them in the right type of exercises for them. You know, if they're a professional sport athlete, they're going to work out completely differently than an actor. And an actor is going to work out differently than a corporate executive, right? And they're going to work differently than you. So everybody needs to do things in a way that is right for them. And that's what I guide people through.
Okay. So, alors, est-ce que vous avez bien compris le sujet en gros, pour être totalement précis? En fait, Reg, effectivement, a écrit son livre bio sur les 10 clés vitales pour vivre une vie extraordinaire. Et ce qu'il propose aujourd'hui, c'est un programme, une masterclass qui vous guide, hein, qui vous emmène et qui vous aide à avoir la méthode pour effectivement alors j'ai des questions en même temps, je répondrai aux questions après, pour effectivement être totalement guidé dans votre évolution avec la méthode de Reg. Ok Reg. I have something to read about Natalie. Natalie, who says, being itself is not the way our generation has been educated.
Exactly.
It's quite hard to realize it at 40 or 50 years old, even if it's never too late. And that's the way. It's never too late, right, Rich?
That's exactly right. In fact, I have a client. If you look on my webpage, there's a testimonial from a client who's 82 years old. And he has, it's great to watch the video, even if you don't understand what he says, because of the passion and the excitement in his face.
Yeah.
And he says, I wish that I had learned about this 50 years ago, but he said, it's never too late.
He speaks Spanish, right?
No, he's British.
I know it's not this video. Okay, I remember a video with a whole man guy who made his exercise.
Oh yeah, no, that's a different man.
It's a different person. Okay. So, great. Alors, what are your favorite keys and why? You have 10 keys, but what are your favorites?
My favorite is assessment. I love to dig out people's superpowers. I love it. Yes. Because, yes, I do. Because I love to see that spark. I love to see people who are depressed and miserable and living a horrible life to all of a sudden totally change and get that spark and that excitement and to completely change their life. I love it.
It gives you energies, right? When you see that. That's right.
It makes me feel like I'm on the planet for a reason.
Okay. Can we follow the keys in the mess or whatever the order?
Sure.
Okay. So, how can your 10 keys change your life? Your life, you.
Me, my life.
Yeah.
How did the 10 change?
Yeah.
Well, because I put it into one word: awareness.
Awareness, okay.
When you look at the 10 keys and you become aware of how you, Gregory, or you, whoever is watching, how you work or live and your beliefs around each one of these 10 keys.
Yeah.
And you become aware of how to use them for yourself. Instead of listening to other people's beliefs and other people's programs and other people's ways of doing it, and you make them your own,
mm-hmm.
everything changes. Okay. Everything changes. And so, I mean, we all need to eat. So we all need to fuel our bodies. So obviously nutrition is exercise is important. We all need to move our bodies, right? We all want to have a body that is going to last us until we're 70, 80, 90, 100 years old. Sure. So we need to exercise. But do we need to go to the gym and do 12 of these every day? No, we don't.
Okay.
So when you create the awareness around the right way to exercise for you and your body to sustain the lifestyle that you want, it becomes fun. You know, it's not, oh, it's something I have to force myself to do.
Okay.
And if you think about people who are living in a body that they hate, they're overweight, they're sick, they're sore, they're depressed, and you try to educate them. If you're a doctor or if you're a therapist or you're a nutritionist or a fitness trainer, it doesn't matter what type of work you're in, and you want to take somebody and help them to go from being a depressed, overweight, unhealthy person to becoming a healthy, happy person, and you try to force them into the gym and try to put them on a diet, that is the hardest thing that person will ever have to go through. And that's why it very rarely works, you know, because it's the wrong way to do it. If you change that around and you start first with getting clear on why are they like that in the first place? Why is somebody 450 pounds or 800 pounds? You know, obviously they're living a life that they hate. So all they do is they simply eat, you know, comfort food, comfort food, comfort food, right? Because they have no passion to go and do anything else. They don't want to go to the gym. Why would they want to go to the gym and exercise and get healthier so that they still have to, now they have more energy to live a life that they hate? There's no desire to do that, right? There's no desire to eat healthier food. You know, why would I stop smoking? Why would I stop drinking? Because smoking makes me feel better to put up and to deal with this horrible life I'm living. Or drinking a lot of alcohol makes me feel better so that I can put up with dealing with this life that I'm stuck living. Right? So when you change that around, when you become aware of why you are the way that you are, why you're making the choices that you're making, why you're living the life you're living in the body you're living, well, all of a sudden everything becomes very, very easy. Very easy. I see people who have, you know, they're right on the verge of dying from a horrible disease, or they've been living in a very, very overweight body their whole life since they were children. You know, it's something that they probably learned from their parents.
Yeah.
And, you know, or, you know, because they were picked on in school or whatever, whatever, they didn't fit into school. So they picked up some bad habits, whether it was eating or drugs or alcohol or whatever, right? Mm. To deal with, to learn how to fit into this life that they've been told they have to live. But as soon as you create that awareness and you go, you don't have to live this way.
Yeah.
I mean, it seems like a simple thing. Mm-hmm. But when I say to somebody, you don't have to live this way, whatever life you're living right now, you don't have to live that way. If you just think about that for a second, it's like, oh, really? You know what I mean? But the problem is people think they have to keep living the life that they're living, which makes perfect sense why they have the issues that they have. Why would you want to keep living a life that you hate living? So it makes sense why people commit suicide or why people have these problems. Mm. Right? But if you help them to realize and become aware, you have a choice. You can change. If I didn't want to be here with you right now, I could hang up the phone right now and go jump in the swimming pool.
The choice is easier, is evident.
Exactly. You know, when people say, oh, it's so hard to change. It's so hard to change. Really? It's hard to change. Boy, it looks pretty hard to live the life that you're living right now. Now, that looks hard.
Yeah.
I couldn't live the life that you're living right now. <They're> like,
maybe you know we love difficulties.
No, it's the belief. It's the, you know, my parents told me I had to. The church told me I had to. The society or the culture or the whatever have told me I have to live this way. Mm. Right?
Right.
But you don't have to. You don't have to. Mm. You know? If you don't like living in the town you're living in, move. You don't like doing the job you're doing, quit. Oh, well, I can't because I have to pay my bills. Really? You want to keep doing a job that you hate doing, living in a house that you hate living with, being surrounded by people that you don't want to be around?
Mm.
I always say, you know, I used to live in Canada, in Vancouver, and I moved out of there as soon as I could because I didn't like the cold. And I remember in the wintertime, you know, I'd be walking down the street and you see these homeless people laying all over the place, freezing to death. And I always thought, why? Why are they homeless here in Canada? I mean, why don't you collect enough pop bottles to get on an airplane and go to Hawaii or go to Thailand or go somewhere where it's hot? I mean, you can be broke and homeless anywhere. Right?
Okay.
But I mean, if you just decide to make a change, yes, change is difficult. I'm not saying it's easy, but I tell you, it's a whole lot more difficult to waste your entire life living a life that you don't want to live than it is to take a few months or a few years to completely change your life.
Yeah. Michel says, we had the very same thought when we visiting Vancouver.
yeah. Cold and wet. Cold and wet. A beautiful city. Nice to visit. But
yeah. In fact, it's a very beautiful town, but it's cold.
Yeah.
Not Acapulco, right?
Not Acapulco, no. No, I would much rather be homeless sleeping on the sidewalk in Acapulco than in Vancouver.
Okay. About your extraordinary life, because you have and you had an extraordinary experiences with famous people, Al Pacino, Hugh Jackman. I love Hugh Jackman. He was sick, right?
Yes. Yeah, he still is.
He still is. Okay.
Yeah, skin cancer.
Okay, and
that's a perfect example of beliefs.
Yeah. Okay. Can you explain? Can you share?
Well, because the problem that these very successful celebrities and professional sport athletes have is that they are owned. They're a commodity. Right, they've signed a contract, and they have to do what everybody else tells them to do because they have sponsors and they have managers and they have, you know, all these people that control their lives.
Okay, they are not free. That's the okay. Nope.
So, and being that the belief on this planet is if you get sick, you have to do what the medical system tells you to do. Well,
okay,
that's why he's still sick.
Okay,
hopefully they don't kill him. But we see it all the time, you know, people die from these diseases when the reality is that, you know, since the 30s, the 1930s, we've had the cure for cancer, you know, and it's proven all the time, all around the world. You know, you go to very poor countries and they have the cure for cancer. Well, how come they have the cure for cancer? But yet you go to the very wealthy countries and you're not even allowed to talk about it. You can't even bring it up in a conversation. And if you bring up cure for cancer, you can actually be thrown in jail. If I was in America, I couldn't say cure. I couldn't even use the word cure. Right? Well, how strange is that? Like, what is that all about, right?
Yes. So. Yes. I understand. I live the same thing in France with family, you know. So it's the same thing all around the world. There is a logic behind our beliefs. I don't know. You think that's beliefs the problem?
Well, of course it is, because why would our government lie to us? Mm. Why would the medical system lie to us? So we want to believe that the people who are there controlling us, you know, setting the rules and setting the standards, that they're there for our benefit.
Yeah. Okay.
But if they were there for our benefit, wouldn't the medical system be a non-profit organization?
Mm.
But it's not. the medical system and the pharmaceutical industry is a multi-trillion dollar industry. I mean, it's a for-profit business.
Yeah.
It's all for-profit. So if it's a for-profit business, why would they release the cure for anything? I mean, could you imagine how much money would be lost if they released the cure for cancer or diabetes or anything else? They would lose trillions and trillions and trillions of dollars. So, of course, they're not going to release the cure.
Okay.
But people won't believe that. When you say that to people, they just think you're crazy.
And about your experiences with all these celebrities, all these beautiful women as Halle Berry, you know. we remember in France Halle Berry in a James Bond. She was awesome. So what is your main best memory, good memory with all these celebrities?
I've got some really, really great memories. One of my favorite celebrities that I work with is Ashley Judd.
Yeah.
She used to phone Ashley me up every morning. Mm-hmm. Ashley Judd, yeah. I used to go over to her house in the mornings and make pancakes together. Pancakes was one of the things that she really enjoyed doing. Beautiful lady, inside and out. I just loved working with her.
Okay.
Gerard Butler was super cool. I had a lot of fun with Gerard Butler. We had a lot of fun together. Did a lot of some cool things. I worked on the movie of I, Robot with Will Smith.
Yes, yes.
Got to ride the Harley Davidson. So that was pretty cool. That was fun.
Okay. Mm. Yeah. She looks like Ashley Judd, right? No.
Pardon?
The actor with Will Smith in I, Robot. How her name? I don't remember.
Oh, jeepers. Good question.
Did you work with her? Did you work with her?
No.
No.
I can't remember.
Okay.
No, I just worked with Will and his family.
Okay. All his family, his son, his wife.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I saw some videos from Will Smith. He is his new point of view. Because I saw interviews, I saw is this because of you? He changed because of you? Will? Ah, on a perdu Reg.
He changed because of him. I don't change people. Okay. People change. People choose to change themselves, right?
You are the guide. Yeah, and
I'm the
hero. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
About your program, est-ce que vous avez des questions? Alors, je le dis en français maintenant. Est-ce que vous avez des questions sur le programme de Rage? Si vous êtes intéressé par ce programme, ce 10 Keys Challenge, I have to put the link on the up here. And vous pourrez découvrir, envoyer à tout le monde. Voilà, j'ai fait une petite erreur. Voilà. I really enjoy hearing that people change themselves if they decide to. Ça, c'est Emily. Emily says that. Emily, a good friend, Emily. And she told me all days, Greg, you are the guide. They are the hero. They decided to change. You are the light. Maybe.
I'm the opportunity.
You are the opportunity. That's the right word, I think. Yeah. You make them feel the energy to change. That's right.
I help them to believe that they have the choice to change.
Yeah. Okay.
And once they realize they have the choice to change, then I can guide and help and support them through that. But if they don't feel that they have the right or the opportunity to change, then there's very little that I can do for them.
Yeah, I understand. And so the 10 keys could help us help everybody because it's a easy program, easy to follow.
Exactly. That's what I like to say, that I like to help people change generations.
Yeah.
Because if you can imagine, you know, if you have a health problem or if you have a depression problem, and I come in and I work with you, mm-hmm. and you have two beautiful children,
yeah.
and you have a beautiful wife. Well, yeah. I help you. Now you become more of a man that can be the father and be the leader of your family.
Mm-hmm.
And so you help your wife, and between yeah. the two of you, you help your children, and you give them better beliefs, and you give them better habits, and you mm-hmm. guide and direct them to be healthier, happier, more free children.
Yeah.
Well, your children are going to grow up with those abilities to pass to their children and to their new who will pass to families, right?
Right.
But if you never meet me, or you never meet me and continue to grow up to live your life in depression or with illnesses, or children grow up in that family with ailments and illnesses and depression, well, what are they going to pass to their children?
Mm. Okay.
Right?
Right.
So I like to believe by me helping people, mm-hmm. that I'm helping people to help generations.
Yeah. That's a beautiful thing. That's a beautiful program.
Yes, it's super, very exciting.
Yeah. So today is the opportunity, in fact, to chosen to follow an easy program, to be aware, to be you, to be us. Alors, je ne sais pas pourquoi je le dis en anglais. I have to say it in French. Donc, c'est vrai que c'est une formidable opportunité aujourd'hui d'avoir un programme accessible, parce que bon, on parle quand même du coach de beaucoup de célébrités, et donc forcément on pourrait avoir some beliefs that it's not for us, but it's for us. It's a program make for us, accessible, facile à retenir, facile à suivre, et c'est une formidable opportunité. Thank you Rage. Alors, I have to say a word. If maybe at the audience, vous qui regardez là en replay ou en live, peut-être que vous avez envie d'avoir un coaching, on va dire, plus personnalisé, plus proche de Commander Rage. Rage, have you got a program one-to-one for people who wants to spend time with you in one-on-one or with a group of person to see Acapulco, to see I don't know where you are coaching, but is it possible
yes.
today?
Yes, absolutely. I have it's my one-to-one program. That's my signature program. It's what I like doing the most.
Okay.
Because that way I can spend one-on-one time with people.
Yeah.
And I work with them physically, emotionally, mentally, and deal with all aspects of their lives, all 10 of the keys.
Okay.
So they can send me an email. They can go yeah. to the website, reglenny.com, okay. or you can okay. send me an email at reg@reglenny.com.
Okay, so I put the email on the conversation. Alors voilà, si vous voulez, si vous avez cette opportunité formidable, si vous avez cette envie, si vous avez, parce que c'est bientôt Noël, hein, it's Christmas, right? We have to have gifts, you know. You are. And maybe the gift this year is to spend time to be coached by the by Reg in Acapulco. Wow! Can you describe that's beautiful behind you? You know,
yes,
seems to be
well. If somebody wants to come to Acapulco with me, I would love to have you here. We are hosting an event for all of December and the first 2 weeks in January.
Okay.
We are hosting events here. So you can come anytime throughout the month of December and January.
Okay.
You can come for a couple of days or you can come and spend the whole month.
Okay.
And we're putting on events and seminars and training, and we'll be doing body therapy, body wisdom training, cooking courses, all kinds of different fun and exciting things.
Okay.
Plus we'll be going out and we'll be doing excursions outside as well, you know, mountain climbing and out on the boat and different events and things.
Ok. Alors, bon, j'espère que vous avez compris, mais voilà, si vous avez envie de vous faire un beau cadeau de Noël, sachez que tout le mois de décembre et tout le mois de janvier, voilà, si vous, on ne sait jamais, si vous partez en vacances, si vous avez un voyage aux États-Unis ou proche du Mexique, hein, à Acapulco, is it far from New York or from United States, Acapulco? Where is it exactly?
No, you fly from any main airport.
Okay.
In United States.
Okay.
Or you can even fly. I've got some clients coming out from Spain and Germany, different areas in Europe. So you fly to Mexico City, basically.
Yeah.
If you want to get anywhere in Mexico, you fly to Mexico City first, and then it's a very easy, just over an hour flight from Mexico City to Acapulco.
Okay.
And then I'll come and pick you up at the airport.
Oh, wow. J'ai envie de venir. Ok. Bon, vous avez compris. Voilà. Si vous êtes dans les parages ou si vous avez vraiment envie de vous faire ce cadeau-là, eh bien, vous envoyez un email à reg@reglenay.com. J'ai mis l'adresse email là. Sachez que du 1er décembre jusqu'au 31 janvier, vous envoyez votre email. Il y a des vols directs, soit d'Europe. Directement à Mexico, et après de Mexico, c'est très facile d'aller à Acapulco. Et en plus, Reg vient vous chercher à l'aéroport, ce qui est quand même the big service. Voilà.
I mean, it is a transformational. The whole idea is to. Sorry.
You're welcome.
Did we get cut off there? Did we get cut off there? Sorry,
yeah, that's
okay. The whole idea is we want to end 2019 in a very powerful way while bringing in 2020. Mm-hmm. You know, I know it's been very difficult for a lot of people, 2019. It's been a very hard year.
Yeah.
So a lot of change, a lot of transformation. So we want to just end that. We want to cut that cord, leave the past in behind. Whatever happened yesterday is done and gone.
Mm-hmm.
So when you come and you spend some time in Mexico with us, the first thing that we'll do is we'll get you on the massage table, and we're going to do a lot of energy work, everything from core balancing, energy balancing, structural realignment, to make sure that the body that you're living in feels fantastic. And while we're doing that, then we start working on the beliefs and the awareness and start creating the new opportunities to create the life that you want.
Okay.
And so, you know, however much time that you spend with us here doing that, that is the work up to the mentorship program, where when you go back home, I will continue to work with you.
Okay.
So you don't just come and learn something and go home and try to figure it all out on your own. My mentorship program is to every day I send you a little video. And so every single day you get a 5-minute video and you get some information that helps you to stay on track. Every week, once a week, we get on the phone and we have live sessions where you can ask me questions and I talk about things and guide you through. And it's a continual guide. It turns into a 12-month program.
Okay.
So we can make sure that you start 2020 in a very powerful way.
Yeah.
And you are guided, directed, and supported through 2020 to really become the person that you want to be and live the life that you want to live.
Okay, so le programme sur 12 mois, en fait, hein, si vous venez à Acapulco ou même si vous venez pas à Acapulco, quoi qu'il arrive, après, vous avez le suivi de Reg à travers un programme, le Lifestyle Mentor, qui peut vous permettre justement de maintenir ce niveau de forme. Ah, je vous ai mis le lien. Ça, c'est vraiment le programme qui peut vous permettre de garder contact avec, avec Reg à travers des vidéos, à travers une plateforme, à travers des événements live pour que justement vous puissiez maintenir. The most difficult thing, Reg, is to maintain the level. That's right.
Exactly.
That's why the lifestyle mentor exists, right?
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah.
Because what I want to do is make sure that along with creating the awareness and helping people to see that they do have a choice is to guide them through. Because the most difficult thing, you know, you go to any of these events or different programs and you learn, oh, I can do anything. I can do anything. Yes, I got lots of power. Then you go home and you don't know how to do it. You don't know how to incorporate it into your own life.
Yes. Right?
So that's exactly what I help you do, is to incorporate that step by step in very simple, very gentle, very loving, easy ways to do that, so that by the end of the year, you are completely different. You're living in a different body. You're living a different life. You're living the life that is right meant for you. And it happened very naturally, very easily and gently. Mm.
Ok, donc pour tout le monde, si je récapitule, voilà, on a quand même, grâce à Reg, on a une palette de possibilités qui sont quand même très intéressantes. La première, c'est les 10 Keys Challenge. C'est un programme qui est totalement accessible. Hein, c'est le premier lien que je vous ai partagé. Je le remets là, parce que je fais un petit récap de tout ce qu'on a dit. The 10 Key Challenge is the first program. You could discover the 10 keys with this link, right? It's an opportunity, a great opportunity to discover the fabulous work of Rage. That's the first choice. The second choice, you could feel to make a trip, to make a retreat, to be with Reg and spend time with him, and to be emotionally connected with Reg. And so you could take a plane to go to Mexico easily. Peu importe où vous êtes, d'Europe, des États-Unis. Reg, après, vient vous chercher. Vous prenez un vol très, très facilement du Mexique, de Mexico City à Acapulco, et il vient vous chercher à l'aéroport. Vous passez du temps avec lui. Et ça, c'est juste une opportunité incroyable. C'est the ultimate retreat. But you have to send an email at Reg for this program, sachant que vous avez l'opportunité de le faire là. Vous êtes totalement libre, en fait, entre le 1er décembre et le 31 janvier. Voilà. You send an email. I am at United States and I will go to Mexico City at this date. And that's okay. Reg est très réactif. Ça va très, très vite. Et après, quoi qu'il arrive, pour garder cette énergie, pour garder cet enseignement-là, vous avez un programme 12 mois, sur 12 mois qui s'appelle le Lifestyle Mentor. Le Lifestyle Mentor permet de maintenir votre niveau pour qu'il y ait un suivi, un vrai travail, pour que vous ne puissiez pas justement rentrer chez vous et vous retrouver seul. Vous êtes accompagné. Tout finalement, c'est très important pour Reg, parce que Reg, ce qu'il veut, c'est vraiment changer des vies, c'est vraiment trouver ce qu'il appelle, voilà, cette conscience, to be aware. What does it mean to be me? So c'est l'énergie que Reg, en fait, met dans ces trois programmes, le premier, le lifestyle, and the retreat. Thank you, Reg, thank you so much. It's a great opportunities. Parle-nous en français, Greg. I'm sorry. Yes. Excuse me. I talk about us in English. You know, my brain. Effectivement, je dois le dire en français, Emily. Tu as tout à fait raison. Emily says talk to us in French, Greg. Talk to us in
yes,
French.
Yes, I wish. I wish.
So, oui, Emily, effectivement, oui, bah oui. Alors, c'est marrant parce que j'ai des petites thanks a lot, Nathalie. Alors, j'ai quand même, hello everyone, I just saw that webinar, I don't hear the sound. I'm sorry. You will check the record, the replay. Valérie says, alors, it's difficult for most people to change because the first step is to learn to know and love themselves. Accepting yes. their failures to change their mindset. A coach is just like a mirror, but people have to do the job. Are you right with Valérie? Rich?
I'll agree with half of what you said.
Yeah,
but
okay.
Yeah, I mean half. It's not.
What is the second half?
I mean, sure. We've all grown up with beliefs and with being told certain things about ourselves.
Yeah.
And being a mirror, I mean, if we come back to somebody who's living a life that they really don't like, you know, they're overweight or they have a disease, there's no point putting a mirror in front of them because it's not going to help them at all. The past is the past. Yesterday is yesterday. 10 minutes ago is finished.
Okay.
You know, what we have is from this point forward. So what my job is again, it's to help people get to the point of who they are and who they want to be and how do we get to where it is that they want to be. You know, and that's what the mentorship program is all about, is to get people from where they are to where they want to be.
Yeah. Okay.
You don't, I mean, I'm not into agreement where, you know, you have these self-help groups where you go sit around and talk about your past for hours or years. You know, there's no point talking about the past. You were already there. You already experienced it. You know it very well. You know, you don't need to keep living that over and over.
Okay.
So, you know, so if people aren't able to come to Mexico, if they're not able to get on a plane, they haven't got the time or the ability or the whatever, feel free to contact me by email because we do the mentorship programs online and over the phone and that sort of thing as well. So I can help people in the way that works best for them.
Okay. Okay. Oui, ce que dit Reg, c'est que même si vous n'avez pas effectivement l'opportunité, les moyens ou le temps de venir à Mexico, évidemment, il suffit de lui envoyer un email à reg@reglaine.com. This is. Je refais la copie de l'email. N'hésitez pas, envoyez un email à Reg. Il y a du coaching online, il y a du coaching par téléphone. Aujourd'hui, Internet est un outil formidable. J'ai pas eu besoin d'aller à Acapulco pour avoir les conseils de Rage et de découvrir son fabuleux programme. C'est ça qui est magique avec Internet. Et il y a du suivi. The main thing is to maintain your level and you will be followed. You will be coached by Rage. And that's a beautiful, beautiful gift for yourself. C'est un très beau cadeau que vous pouvez vous faire à vous-même. Voilà, c'est très facile à comprendre. Alors, je voulais juste vous dire un truc, c'est que, bon, vous voyez, mon niveau d'anglais n'est pas terrible, d'accord? Mais pourtant, je comprends tout ce qu'il dit. Et donc, si... il viendrait l'envie, ou même si vous sentez cette énergie incroyable de suivre, d'avoir envie de suivre en tout cas le programme de Reg, que ce soit les 10 keys, que ce soit le lifestyle ou que ce soit le trip à Acapulco, peu importe, eh bien, soyez totalement rassurés parce que vous avez une double opportunité. La première opportunité, c'est évidemment de bénéficier du guide Reg. De cette formidable personne avec 33 ans d'expérience et d'améliorer votre anglais au final parce que vous allez prendre confiance et en gros c'est deux programmes en un pour nous les Français parce que finalement voilà, si on passe du temps avec Reg et qu'on parle en anglais, qu'on comprend tout ce qu'il dit et qu'on s'ouvre, et non seulement vous allez découvrir Be You, vous allez découvrir Be You et en plus, vous allez progresser en anglais. So, pour moi, c'est une double opportunité. Il n'y a pas très longtemps, il y a quelques instants, Jean-Marc m'appelle et me dit, Oh Greg, mais comment tu vas faire? Ben, je vais lui dire, écoute, je vais accéder à mon état mental optimal et puis ben, je vais faire la conférence avec Reg. Et Jean-Marc sait très bien que mon niveau d'anglais, il n'est pas terrible, il est juste scolaire. Et pourtant, is it okay, right, with my awesome French accent, right?
I love your French accent.
Non, mais the French
are known for having the best accent on the planet, aren't they?
Ah, ben voilà. Listen to him. Écoutez-le. C'est voilà. We have the most beautiful accent in the world.
Of course.
I always explain that we have French people. We have two opportunities: is to be with you and to be to improve his English. You know, and voilà.
Yes. Alors, well, I tell you, I honestly believe that my coaching and my mentoring is the most valuable thing that you could ever do for yourself and your family.
Yeah,
it really is. And for everybody that's listening right now with us live, if you send me an email, mm-hmm. I will give you some time with me one-on-one, just the two of us, we can chat about, so that's a free gift offer that I'm willing to offer right now. So everybody that is interested in having a one-on-one, some private time with me, send me an email and I'll spend some time with you. No charge, no obligation.
Okay.
And hopefully I can help you a little bit with whatever you're going through.
Wow, thank you so much. That's a beautiful gift. Alors, pour ceux qui n'ont pas compris, mais je vais le dire en français pour que ce soit clair. Reg vient de vous offrir, vous qui voyez cette vidéo, vient de vous offrir un coaching en one-to-one, c'est-à-dire vous lui envoyez un email. Il a vraiment envie de vous aider. Pour lui, c'est son énergie, sa passion. Et voilà, vous allez bénéficier d'un échange avec Reg, d'un coaching avec Reg, totalement gratuit, no charge, rien du tout, parce que vous êtes là, parce que vous faites partie des membres de la Towers Academy, parce que c'est Reg, voilà, c'est beautiful Reg, thank you Reg for this gift, voilà, c'est Noël avant l'heure, les amis. Donc profitez-en, je vous remets l'email vraiment parce que c'est très important. Il suffit d'envoyer un mail aujourd'hui à Reg pour dire ben voilà, j'étais là, j'ai vu votre vidéo avec Grégory, vous étiez à Acapulco, vous aviez bonne mine et voilà, je vous envoie un email parce que j'ai très envie que vous m'aidiez à devenir moi. Tout simplement, et à suivre après, vous révéler, être plus conscient et suivre les conseils avisés sans charge, sans rien, voilà, totalement gratuit, c'est son offre. Voilà, un coaching gratuit avec Reg, ça vaut son pesant de cacahuètes, croyez-moi, j'en ai fait l'expérience. Voilà, et je peux vous dire que je suis un autre homme aujourd'hui, et la preuve, voilà, j'ai tout pété, tous mes plafonds de verre, il n'y a plus de plafonds de verre, il n'y a que de l'énergie, voilà. So Reg, thank you so much. Thank you for this gift. Thank you for your time, your energy, your patience. I'm so proud, bro. I'm so proud to be me and to discuss with you, to talk with you, to listen to you. You're a great person. You voilà, c'est mon mentor, hein. Qu'est-ce que vous voulez que je vous dise? Thank you. It's the end of the conference. Have you some questions maybe for? Excusez-moi, je dois le dire en français. Avez-vous des questions sur Reg? Emily says so generous. Thank you, Emily. Thank you so much, Reg. Dit adieu.
Thank you now,
huh?
I'm still stuck on the kisses, but the adieu is nice as well.
Voilà, Bernard Mallet. Ah, it's my father, Bernard Mallet, you know, Reg. Bon, papa, il faut que t'envoies un mail à Reg. OK, Bernard Mallet, voilà. So, thank you. Est-ce que vous avez des questions? Emily qui dit just like me, I talk English like a Spanish co. Thanks a lot. Michel, des commentaires à mon retour. C'est très généreux. Voilà. Écoutez, vous êtes sage ce soir. Sarah est là, Nathalie est là. Merci d'être ici avec nous. Merci à vous qui voyez cette vidéo en replay. Notez bien, même si vous n'étiez pas en live, c'est reg@reglaney.com, reglaney.com. Vous envoyez un email et vous bénéficiez d'un coaching totalement offert, gratuit, free. C'est Noël, c'est Papa Noël. Reg is close tonight, right?
I'm always open.
So, voilà, c'est Noël avant l'heure, les amis. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Reg.
Thank you all for your time. Thank you for joining us. I'm glad that you all joined us and shared your energy with us as well.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. So, bye-bye. Have a nice day.
Okay. All right. Good night, thanks, everybody.
Et puis, à très bientôt. Okay. À très, très vite, Reg. Okay. Bye, Reg.
Okay. Ciao. Bye-bye.
Bye.